I am Pavagada Manjunath, lecturer in physics. In this video clip, I explain previous year physics Karnataka question paper. A student must know this. By knowing this, a student can score maximum marks by minimum effort. For example, by 50% of the effort, you can score 85 to 90 marks. Or by 60% of the effort, you can score 95 to 100 marks. How is it possible? For this, student has to watch this video. I have been teaching for second year PC students for 25 years. Every year, I involve twice in paper evaluation. In 25 years, I have involved in paper evaluation for 50 times. Out of this experience, I discuss this previous year question paper. A student is required to know this one. So, share this link to the Karnataka PU students. So, continue watching this video. For my question paper analysis, I am taking March 2014 physics question paper. First, let us know the pattern of the question paper. We know this physics question paper consists of four parts. That is part A, part B, part C, and part D. There are four parts because there are four types of questions. One mark question, two mark question, three mark question, and five mark questions. Look here in part A, there is one subpart. In this one, there are 10 one mark questions. Answer all the following. Means there is no choice in this part. In the next part B, there is one subpart. It is a second one. Here there are 8 two mark questions. Answer any 5 of the following questions. There are 3 choices. And in part C, there is one subpart. That is third one. Here also there are 8 three mark questions. Answer any 5 of the following. So there are 3 choices. In part D, there are 3 sub parts. Fourth one, fifth one, and sixth one. In the fourth one, there are 3 5 mark questions. Answer any 2 of the following questions. There is one choice. In the fifth, 30, 31, 32, there are 3 5 mark questions. Answer any 2 of the following. Here also there is one choice. And look here in the sixth part. This is the problem part. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 problems are there. Answer any 3 of the following questions. So here there are 2 choices. Now let us discuss the part D, because in part D 5 mark questions are there and 50% of the marks are there in part D. This is part D. It is important to know from which part of the syllabus these questions are asked. Look here in our syllabus there are 2 parts. Look here, part 1 and part 2. Part 1 consists of electric charge and field to electromagnetic waves. There are 8 chapters. Part 2 consists of the 9th chapter to 15. So the syllabus is divided into 15 chapters. The same syllabus is divided into 10 units like this. There is a rule. This questions in the fourth part must be selected from this first part. Questions from this fifth part must be selected from the second part. As you have to answer for 2 questions out of 3, it is not necessary to practice 5 mark questions in all these chapters. It is enough to practice 5 mark questions in 4 or 5 chapters. I will discuss later, which chapter is important in this respect. In this part also, fifth part also, only two questions have to be answered out of three. Therefore, here also three or four chapters are enough for practice of these five mark questions. Now let us discuss about problems. So this is problem part. Here there are five problems and there is a rule. In the syllabus, each problem has to be selected from alternative or two successive units. For example, this first problem must be selected from first unit or second unit. Second problem must be selected from third or fourth. And this one must be from these two. Like this, in two successive chapters, each problem has to be selected. Therefore, here in this part, only three problems are required to be answered. Therefore, it is not necessary to practice problems in all these 15 chapters. It is just enough to practice in six chapters, because from first unit and second unit, we get one problem. Third and fourth, we get the second problem. And for the third one, let us go for this seventh and eighth unit. So just by these six units, you can answer all the three problems so that you can get out of out marks in this part. So in this respect, it is enough to see, enough to consider 1, 2, 3, 4 and 9, 10, these six chapters. Of course, in NEET or JEE or CET, problems are going to be asked from all these chapters. For them, it is not necessary to practice this type of problems, long stepped problems. They need a problems of 2 to 3 steps. Now let us go back to the question paper. Look here, in 3 hours 15 minutes, student has to answer for 70 marks. So here, the examination starts at 10 a.m. At 10 a.m. invigilator gives only question paper to the student. After 15 minutes, that is at 10:15, he provides answer papers. So from 10 to 10:15, in this gap of 15 minutes, student has to read all the questions. So when he read all the questions, his brain or mind starts to search answer for these questions. So the mind is not capable of providing answers instantaneously. Just like in the internet, in the Google search engine, if you type a website or a question, it doesn't give the answer instantaneously. It buffers for few minutes or few seconds. Similarly, the mind starts to search answers for these questions. So at 1:15, student has to hand over his answer paper to the examiner. So 10:15 to 1:15, 3 hours. In 3 hours, he can answer for 70 marks. Now let us discuss general instructions. Look here, A. All the parts are compulsory. Means part A, part B, part C, part D are compulsory. B. Answers without relevant diagram or figure or circuit, wherever necessary, will not carry any marks. It means in 5 mark derivations or 3 mark derivations, diagram or figure or circuits are required. The student has to draw the diagram and then he has to derive. Suppose he derives entire derivation correctly without the diagram or figure or circuit, he will get no mark. He gets a 0 mark. Therefore, it is very important to draw diagram or figure or circuit. Next, Direct answers to the numerical problems without detailed solutions will not carry any marks. Some students, even they mug up problems and solutions for them. As soon as he reads the numerical problem, he answers it. He put the solution or answer directly without solving. Even though the solution is correct, he gets 0 mark. Because for every step, marks are allotted. So in case of numerical problems, he has to write first the formula, then substitution, then calculation, and finally he has to write answer with relevant unit. Now let us discuss few points. Look at the question numbers. Look here in part 1, question number 1, 2, 3, like this they are continuous. In part B, it is 11, after this 10. And in part C, look at it, is 19 after 18. So in part D, it is 27 after 26. So like this, question numbers are continued. There are 37 questions are there in this question paper. So while answering, the student has to write the question number in the answer paper and then he has to write the answer. It is not necessary to write the question again in the answer paper. Even it is not necessary to write part A, first one answer the following questions and all these things. So by avoiding all these things, you can save time. But it is very important to write the correct question number and correct answer for it. Another point, it is not necessary to follow the same order. It means a student can write answer for the fourth one first, then for third one, then for sixth one, then for first one, like this. Even you can answer first for the part B, next part A, next part D, like that. It means it is not necessary to follow the order of the question. While answering, student may need to do rough work or some calculations. In order to maintain the neatness of the answer paper, you should not write the calculation or rough work on the question paper or on his hand or anywhere else. You should do his rough work or calculations only in the answer paper, because sometimes the rough work or calculation also carry marks. So what he has to do? In the answer paper, he has to draw a line at the edge, and within this margin, he can do the rough work or calculations. For calculations, student may bring ordinary calculator, not the scientific calculator. For some calculations, he may need a logarithmic table. The logarithmic table will be provided by pre-university education. If the student asks for it, the invigilator provides it. Now let us discuss the time management. We know there are 4 parts, part A, part B, part C, and part D in question paper. So in part A, 1 mark questions are there, part B 2 mark, C 3 mark, part D 5 mark questions are there. So look here, in part A, it has one sub part, first one, here second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one. It means in part D there are 3 parts. And number of questions given in this part, 10, in second one, 8, here also 8, in fourth one, 3, fifth one also 3, and here it is 5. Totally there are 37 questions in the question papers. And of course these are the marks. 10 into 1 it is 10. 10 into 8 into 2 it is 16, like that. Totally 105 marks. I mean the question paper, in the question paper questions are there for 105 marks. But look here. So 1 mark question, 2 mark question, 3 mark question, total marks is equal to 50. These are 5 mark questions, total marks is equal to 55, almost 50-50. Look here, 50 plus 55, it is 105. So now, student has to answer for. So 10 out of 10 in this part, and here 5 out of 8, here 5 out of 8, here 2 out of 3, 2 out of 3, and here 3 out of 5. Totally there are 27 questions he has to answer. Look here, out of 37, student has to answer 27. There are 10 questions choice. So now 10 into 1, 1 mark, 5 into 2 mark, like this. 10 into 1 it is 10, 10 into 2, 5 into 2 it is 10. The total of these marks is equal to 70. Student has to score 70 to get out of out. Look here, out of 105, he has to answer for 70 marks. So here, look here, 1 mark question, 2 mark question, 3 mark questions. The total marks 35. These are the 5 mark questions, total marks 35. So 50% of the marks from 1, 2, 3 marked questions, and 50% marks from 5 marked questions. And here now let us discuss the time management. So here, if student takes 2 minutes for 1 mark question, 10 into 2, it takes 20 minutes. For 2 mark question to answer, if it takes 4 minutes, 5 into 4, it is 20. Like this, for 3 mark question, it takes 6 minutes. For 5, it is 10. For 5 mark, 10, and of course, it is 10. For each problem, he has to take 10 minutes. So like this, total number of minutes is equal to 140. So in 140 minutes, that is 2 hours 20 minutes, he can answer for all the 70 marks. But he is provided with 3 hours. 3 hours is equal to 3 into 60, it is 180 minutes. 180 minus 40, it is equal to 40 minutes. So he is remained with 40 minutes. In these 40 minutes, the student can once again go through the question paper and also the answer. So somewhere you might have not answered for some questions. Now you can answer for it, and also now you can answer for choices. And also if somewhere you might have done the wrong answers, you can verify it and you can write the correct answer. So here, look here, 1 mark questions, 2 mark questions, 3 mark questions, it requires 70 minutes for answering this 20, 20, 40 plus 30, it is 70 marks, 70 minutes. Again, for 5 mark questions also, you need 70, 50, 50, 70 plus 70, it is 40, 140. So this is how a student can manage the time. Actually, before the examination, he has to practice answering in 2 minutes for 1 mark, in 4 minutes for 2 marks, and in 10 minutes for 5 mark, like this. At his home, he has to practice it so that he can answer all the questions in 3 hours, even including choices, so that there will be more chance to get out-of-out marks. Let us discuss few more points. In the beginning, student required to answer for the required questions. For example, in part B, there are 8 questions, but answer any 5 of the following questions. So first he has to answer for 5 questions, and he has to answer choices after completion of the entire question paper. So if he answers all the questions in the beginning, so in this part, like this, so finally, you may not get time to solve these problems. Therefore, first, he has to answer for the required questions. Then finally, he has to answer for choices also. Student is not recommended to leave the hall before the final bell rings, because at the end you can reread the questions and also answers, and there will be a chance to alter the answers. And also You can find the questions for which he has not written answer, even though he knows answer for it. For such questions, you can write the answers. Now let us consider few question papers. Look at 2014 March, July, 15 March, July, 16 March, July, 17 March. And let us analyze. Look here, these are the chapters. This is electric charge and electric field, electric potential and capacitance, electric current and Kirchhoff's laws, moving charges and magnetism, magnetism and matter, electromagnetic induction, AC, electromagnetic waves, ray optics, wave optics, dual nature, atom, nuclei, and your semiconductor and communication system. Look here, this is the first part and this is the second part. And there are 15 chapters divided into 10 units. And look here in the March, one more question, two more question, three more question, five more question. So in this chapter, one more question is asked and one two more question is asked. There is no three mark question. Five mark derivation is asked in this March. Like this, marks are allotted. So let us concentrate on five mark questions. I mean, five mark derivation and problem. Look here, in these two chapters or in these two units. Look here in the year 2014 March question paper. One derivation and one problem is asked. And in July, one derivation, one problem. Even in 2015, there is one derivation, one problem. 2000, of course, in the July also derivation problem. In 2016 question paper, in the March derivation problem, in the July derivation problem. Only 2017, there is a problem, but there is no derivation. This is shifted year. So from this, we can conclude that. So if we practice derivation and problem in these two chapters, we get at least one derivation and one problem. And the third unit, electric current and Kirchhoff's laws. Look here, derivation in the 2014 March, derivation problem, like this. Look here, derivation problem. So here we get one derivation and one problem. So again, in this moving charge and magnetism, in the 2014 derivation, and again it is not there, here derivation like this. And from these four chapters, 1, 2, 3, 4 chapters, we get derivation 1, 2. And 3, of course, sometimes 3, sometimes 2. So we get minimum 2 derivations. So in this part, there are 3 questions. You have to answer for only 2. So by practicing these 2, it is enough. So by practicing these 4 chapters, 2 long answer questions and 2 problems can be answered. For another problem, we have to see in this part. So like this, so in the first part, these 4 units or chapters are important, and by just we have to see long answers, derivations, 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark questions only in these 4 chapters. And it is not necessary to see problems and long answers in remaining chapters, that is magnetism and matter, electromagnetic induction, AC, electromagnetic waves. It is just enough 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 questions in these chapters. When we come to this part 2, look at the ray optics and wave optics. Here one problem, derivation, derivation, problem, like this. In all the question papers, one problem and derivation comes from first 2 chapters. And here look at this semiconductor. It carries 10 marks. So long answer, that is 5 mark question. Here long answer 5 mark in all question papers, one 5 mark question is asked. So like this, here one derivation, here one 5 mark long answer, that is 2 5 mark questions are covered, and here one problem is covered, and here 2 problems are covered in the first part. 2 plus 1 3, it is enough. Out of 5, you will have to answer only 3, and here 2 derivations covers. So by practicing this first chapter, second chapter, third chapter, fourth chapter, fifth, this one, ninth, tenth, and this 14, totally 7 chapters. Out of 15 chapters, just by practicing these 7 chapters, you get maximum marks. Look here, how many marks you are going to get? Look here it is 8 plus 8, 16 plus 13, it is 29 plus 8, it is 37. 37 plus 8, it is 45. 45 plus 8, it is 53. And it is 10, 63. So, 63 marks plus 30 in the lab, totally 93 marks. Just by practicing 7 units or 7 chapters, you can get easily 90 to 93 marks. If you little bit go beyond, that is, even if this ninth unit is practiced, then you will get 95 to 100 marks. It means it is not necessary to practice problems in all these chapters. It is just enough to practice in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 chapters problems, and in 7 chapters long answer questions. In all remaining 1, 2, 3 marks are enough. Like this, we can save time, energy, and we can score more marks. So, this is the analysis of question papers. In the next video, I am going to give solutions for previous year question papers. For that, I have taken this book as the source. This is the Legend Study Material, Easy Path to Success, Second Year PUC PCMB Combined. This is published by Madana Gopala Publications, Bangalore. This contains solutions for previous year question papers for physics, chemistry, maths, biology, and also it contains solutions for model question papers released by our pre-university board, and also there are very important expected questions, and solutions for all these questions are arranged chapter wise, and of course this is, I think, one of the good books. So this is